Well, what is life going to be like when 80% of the country is vaccinated? While we don't have a crystal ball, we can look at Singapore, which has hit that target.
Yeah, restaurants are open, people are getting back to work, but it's not the picture of Freedom Day Australians might be expecting. Simon Hayes joins us now from Singapore. Good morning, thanks for your time. So what is life like in Singapore at 80% vaccinated?
Well, it does feel like life is largely getting back to normal. As you noted, we're able to go out to restaurants. We're able to be back in the office. What I think the government really is doing, though, is being very, very cautious and careful. So we need to continue to wear masks both indoors and outdoors, unless, of course, we're eating or drinking. There are limitations on group sizes. And if we do want to eat out in restaurants, we need to be vaccinated. So there are quite a few restrictions in place. And all of that really is just aimed at making sure that hospitals don't get overwhelmed. I think it's actually quite instructive for what Australia could look like when it does hit that magic 80%.
Yeah. Would you have expected more freedoms at this point, or do you think it's pretty much on track?
I think the way that the health minister described it is neither reversing nor racing ahead. Singapore has always taken things quite cautiously, and I think in some ways that is pretty reassuring. The government is saying that we're going through a wave at the moment. The government is saying we could hit about 3,000 cases a day. So they are watching ICU capacity and ICU utilisation. So I think we wouldn't really have expected anything other than that they would keep some things in reserve and some measures in reserve just to keep a track of what's going on and to keep a cap on the number of cases as well. I think, frankly, I think it's very sensible. And I think it is, as I said, quite instructive for the way it could play out for Australia, which has adopted a fairly cautious posture as well.
Yeah, so you think Singapore has taken the right approach compared to countries like Israel and the UK, where there are much freer, but cases are skyrocketing?
Yeah, they may be much freer, but I think there's actually not the same difference between the UK strategy and the Singapore strategy that people think there is. So the UK could well reintroduce mask wearing. It could well extend the October school holidays. I think there are a lot of things in the UK that are actually quite controlled as well, despite the announcement of Freedom Day. And I think that's just the reality for the world going forward. I think we will need to live with some continued restrictions. And hopefully we can continue a fairly normal life even with those restrictions. I think the good news, though, is that evidence both from Singapore and the UK seems to be pointing to the fact that the nexus between infection on the one hand and serious illness on the other is actually being reduced, frankly, post-vaccination. So that's some good news, at least.
Singapore, where you are, is obviously a much smaller country than Australia, but in essence, what is your message to us lot as we race towards that golden 80% mark?
I think the message, quite frankly, is hope for the best, hope for the best, but prepare for the worst. You need to be prepared. I think you're going to need to expect to have some continued controls in place. That's just unfortunately all there is to it. But life will get back to at least a semblance of normality as we start to transition. So go get vaccinated. I think that's probably the most important thing that I can say.
And we will hopefully see you soon, with Singapore expected to be part of a bubble very, very soon. Good on you, Simon. Thank you.
Plan the date and cross your fingers. Thank you, Simon. Yeah.